What's going on, guys? SP Architects here. Today I want to show you how to create topo surface in ARCHICAD, but this time we are going to use the CAD mapper website. With the CAD mapper you can place any location into your project. It's not completely free, but if you are going to use a limited area, it's free for you. How it works? First, we are going to define a map area and we are going to export that area into any kind of drawing file. It can be DWG, it can be SketchUp file or 3ds Max file. With the CAD mapper, you can place any kind of surface around the world into your ARCHICAD. Up to 1 km is free, but more than 1 km, it's going to be cost additionally, but for the starting point, the first 1 km is enough for us. Now, let's start. Of course, at the beginning, you need to sign up the account. It doesn't important. I have already done that. And for the second page here, you will see this area. And as you can see the Istanbul grabbed area. Since ARCHICAD is using for the importing models for SketchUp, we are going to select the SketchUp file. Of course, if you are going to use the Revit file, you can use the AutoCAD or other formats, but since we are going to use the ARCHICAD file, we are going to use the SketchUp file. Now we have additional options here. We can include the 3D buildings and also we can combine it with the topography additional contour lines. You can change the contour lines here. I set up them to 5 meters and also I set up the false height meters to 3. Of course you can change all of these values. If your area contains road geometry, you can change their heights. As you can see, we have highways, major roads, minor roads and paths. Since our area doesn't have any kind of this road geometry, I leave them as is. Now let's go to create file. To change the area, as you can see, we have a box here. We have points to change. As you can see, we can grab the area, but as you can see, now it says buy map for additional price. And also from here, purchase file, you can see the area of your file. It's 1.36 km and you can purchase file up to 100 km. Free file is up to 1 km. Now of course we are going to reduce the area to make it free. Now it's free. Let's click create file. And after that you will see a screen like this. And you will see a 3D axonometric view, 3D view and your topography. If this is okay for you, you will just click this download and it's going to be downloaded in your computer. Now let's switch to ARCHICAD. Alright guys, here we are in ARCHICAD and we are going to import that file into our ARCHICAD file. To do this, we will go to the file menu and from here we will go to external content, interoperability, merge and merge from file, and from here we will change the file type to SketchUp and then we will just double click or click open. Now we need to change the location information. It's not important. I'm just going to click override project location with imported textures, imported coordinates. Let's click OK and place our map. Now our map is, our 3D map is in the ARCHICAD file and as you can see, it's slightly rotated. Let's fix that first. Let's click the mesh and rotate slightly. Click here and click here and align it to the X direction. Of course, if you want to do that, you can move your mesh to your reference zero coordinate. And if I hit the F3, I will see something like this. Of course, you can see this 3D file completely as you can see and like this, or you can just change its textures, or maybe you want to modify the buildings according to your project. But now, if I click it, well, I cannot make any modifier. It's an object. So how we are going to edit this object? Yes, I can hear you because you are watching my tutorials. We are going to explode this object. To do it, we are going to click this object, right click and click convert selection to morph and click OK. Now, let's continue. I know it's very complex profile, complex model. As you can see, our 3D model is ready. This is a morph file, but this is some kind of a group. Let's suspend the group first by clicking this icon. Now, I click this and hit F5. I will see this. This is our 3D but non-solid surface. Hit F5 again, and this time, as you can see, I can select the buildings. Suspend the group. Again, select the group. Hit the shift and click the surface. And now we only select our 3D models. Hit F5 and we will see it. Also, you can group them. It's very easy. You will just hit the Ctrl plus F. And from here, hit the Alt, select the morph face. Now we click Add. And from here, we are going to search for body type. And we have two options, non-solid and solid. Let's click solid and hit the plus. As you can see, we grabbed all of the 3D buildings and now we can change their layer. Hit the Ctrl plus L, create a new layer and type in here 3D or just buildings. And after that, click this open eye, click the save, and from here, assign that our new layer to these 3D buildings. Just like that. After that, I hit cancel. This time, I will select the non-solid, hit plus, hit F5, accept this. As you can see, they are all lines. So we are going to create a different layer for the remaining lines. So now we are going to hit Ctrl plus A to select all of them, hit the shift. Now we select all of the lines, Ctrl plus L to open up the layer menu, create a new layer. I'm gonna call this 2D lines. Well, I can hear you. You are saying lines are already 2D. Okay. I'll do it anyway. Now we have 2D lines and make it visible. Click OK, change layer, select 2D lines, or well, you can use the ready to use the 2D drafting general. It's up to you. Now I'll select this two. It's going to be buildings. Now I hit F5. I will see all of the buildings right now. You can use this very stylistic. To do it, you will go to this graphic override combinations. And from here, you will create a new combination. Let's click new. And let's call this style 1. After that, we are going to click this add new rule. And from here, I'm gonna call this buildings. Let's manage this rule. And all types of element type will be 3D, or let's click add layer. Layer name will be building, and I want to change the surface to a kind of glass, maybe this one. Let's change line marker. Let's make it white, and I want this to be affected with only 3D buildings, so I'm going to assign this as 3D types. Let's click OK, and this is what we get. Alright, now we have this very ugly solid color, this morph color. Now we are going to change this color to match with the Google Earth. Therefore, I'm going to open up the real location of this file. Alright, here we are in Haliç in Istanbul. Now we are going to grab this texture into ARCHICAD. How we are going to do this? Now, at first, I'm going to see my contour and define our area. If I grab an area like this from this Google Earth, it's going to work for us. Let's just zoom inside And of course, you can open the 3D buildings. It's not important for now. Just click this node. And I think we will see this point. It's here. This is the most cube. So we can get closer. And maybe something like this. As you can see, we will see third bridge. 1, 2, and 3. Maybe zoom out a little. Yeah, this may work. And after that, we are going to save this as image. From the file, save and save image. Let's change the resolution to maximum. And then we will click this save. And here we have exported our image file at its maximum resolution. We can zoom very closer. We can even see the cars, peoples, and it's very convenient using this image file for our 3D model in ARCHICAD. Let's switch back to ARCHICAD. And from here, to do that, we are going to import that file first. Let's go to floor plan. And we are going to create a new worksheet. Let's right click it and click new independent worksheet and click create. Let's go to file menu and external content and place external drawing. And I'm going to import that file into ARCHICAD. It's updating right now. And there we go. Now let's scale this up or down or rotate, match the scale, whatever. Let's right click this ground floor, click show as trace reference. As you can see, there is a very different extent of scale. So in order to fix that, we will click our reference image and we are going to choose a reference coordinate. At the first, I want to use that point to match them. I think it's here. Let's move this to here. And unfortunately, I cannot see the reference line from the ground floor. To see it better, we are going to click this trace reference. And from here, we have some options reference on top. Let's click that. And now we can see it clearly. Of course, you can change this color too and change it to red. After that, to active one, we will slightly reduce that to see the red better. And let's hit Ctrl plus K, click OK. From here to here, I don't know, maybe something like this. Let's do it a couple of times. It's going to be here. And let's move this to here. Again, slightly move. Hit Ctrl plus K, resize, and we have a mouse view here. Let's reduce a little. Yeah, I think we can probably use that. Let's correct the scale. Maybe there are differences in the original site from the CAD mapper. You know, these are always growing and adding new different lands and projects. Like this. I'm going to try this match here from this corner. Or first, maybe rotating it will be rotating will be very good idea to here. Again, here to here. Yeah, way more correct. As you can see, roads are also aligned. Now we are going to use that. Let's hit the F3. And how we are going to import that image into our 3D morph? Let's do that. Let's go to surface. and create a new surface by clicking this new. I'm gonna call this reference image, or just reference. Let's click OK, and then we are going to locate our file. And by clicking this icon, we are going to search and browse for our image. We will click this add, and it's going to open our folders. There we have found our image, our Halic file. Double click that, and we will see it in this folder with the name with the JPEG. Let's click OK. And now we are going to change this dimensions horizontal size, but actually we don't know the actual values for this image. So we are going to learn them from the ground floor or our worksheet. Let's hit the M. It's going to be start from here and to here. Let's hit the tab and copy. Now let's go back to our surface. And let's just paste it to here. If you click this chain, you won't need to change this second box. It's going to be fulfilled automatically. Let's click OK. Let's select our file, let's select our mesh, and select our reference. After assigning this, we are going to adjust the aligning. How we are going to do that? Well, let's go back, go to design, let's create another morph. But this time, we are going to right click this worksheet, click show as trace reference. Let's click this rotated rectangular and create a rectangular shape. It's going to be visible in 3D. After that, we will select our morph, and from here we have shortcut, or you can just go to document and go to creative imaging, align 3D texture, and we are going to set the origin. It's going to be here. After that, we will rotate slightly. To do it, it's very important. We are going to select our morph, and after that, we click our rotate image. And then, this part is very important. We are going to select this face. Face is important. After that, we are going to define angle graphically. Let's click OK. We have two options here. We can just directly click this edge, or we can create our reference edge by clicking first point and then clicking second point. As you can see, it was aligned correctly according to our reference image. Now we can get rid of this, and our file is ready to use. By using that, you can import original 3D buildings. As you can see, we will see a historical mosque. You can delete like so and import real model, or you can just model yours. Alright guys, that was all for this tutorial. I hope you have enjoyed it. If so, do not forget to hit the like button. If you have any questions or suggestions, you can comment in the comment section below. And if you are serious about learning ARCHICAD, you can go to my Patreon page. From there, I will be waiting for you. Alright, thank you for watching. Until next time, have a nice day. Bye.